Hi and welcome to the fourth video in the series about populations. Today we're going to be looking at answering exam questions. And so the exam questions we're going to look at today are in relation to the A-level AQA biology course, and specifically this is the Unit 4 paper. And so if we read through the question 7 first, so parasites are organisms that live on or in host organisms. The population of many organisms may be reduced by the effects of parasites. Feather mites are small parasites found on the wing feathers of many birds. The mites feed on the oil that the birds produce. This oil keeps the feathers in good condition. Birds are unable to oil their feathers properly, use more energy in maintaining their body temperature. This results in less energy being available for other processes. Scientists investigated the relationship between the number of feather mites and the breeding success of one species of bird, the great tit. Use information above to suggest how feather mites could affect breeding in great tits. So the question is very specific in turn, use information above to see how the mites could affect breeding in great tits. So the first thing you need to notice is the mites, they feed on the oil that the birds produce, and this oil keeps the feathers in good condition. So clearly, an increased number of mites or mites will affect the condition of the feathers. That would clearly be one mark. This results in less energy being available for other processes, namely reproduction. So mentioning the fact that there's less energy available for reproduction would be another mark. And therefore, this final section here, how it could affect the breeding in great tits, it would therefore reduce the amount of breeding. It wouldn't stop it, but it would reduce it. So that's very, very key. You couldn't say the birds would be unable to breed. It just means that the amount of breeding would be less, and that could be potentially a third mark. And therefore, only two from those are valid. 7b, the scientists located a large number of great tit nests. They sampled these at random. For each, they recorded the total number of eggs laid, the number of chicks that hatched from the eggs, the number of chicks that survived to leave the nest, and the total number of feather mites on the two parent birds. Explain why the scientists sampled the nests at random, and that is worth two marks. Now, the above information is gauche at this point. It doesn't really influence what the answer will be here. And this is a standard question that you'd expect to do with sampling. So sampling means to take numbers down of the numbers living in a certain area, and therefore it needs to be done at random. This is a consistent question that you'd expect. It needs to be done at random to avoid bias. That's a clear mark. And from there, you could then go on to talk about how picking the nests at random or picking the sites at random wouldn't influence the results, because if somebody was picking them and you were looking at doing a sample and you were picking the areas you wanted to, obviously that would sway the results somewhat. So that would be the second mark. And the third mark is you'd be able to then apply a statistical test. The scientists calculated the percentage of each pair's eggs from which chicks survive to leave the nest. This is called, they called this breeding success per pair. The table shows some of the data that the scientists obtained. And so you've got the total numbers of mites on both parent birds and breeding success per pair. 7b part 2. Do these data support the hypothesis that the presence of feather mites reduces the ability of great tits to reproduce successfully? Give reasons for your answer. Now, this is very similar to an evaluate style question where you look at the data and you give reasons maybe for and against. And so in this case, a piece of evidence that's for it, you might say something along the lines of the birds, the parent birds with the highest values of mites, so the 170, has the lowest breeding success per pair rate. So it has the lowest number for that. And that would clearly be a reason to believe or to have support in the hypothesis. Conversely, a reason against that, the number of feather mites for the which was at naught, didn't have the highest breeding success per pair. Obviously, the value for 2 is higher at 100, and that would be a reason against. And clearly, that would be a mark. Now, if you look at the values for 0 through to 15, there doesn't really seem to be a pattern as it goes up, down, up, down, up. There's relatively no pattern whatsoever. And so for a third mark, saying that there's no correlation or no pattern from 0 to 15 would be another mark. And also, another reason for not having confidence in the hypothesis is the fact that there's no values between 15 and 170, and so that could potentially be a fourth mark there. Okay, so going back to a question earlier on in the papers, this is question 4A. What is meant by birth rate? So a single mark, and it's just a clear definition. So the birth rate is the number of births per 100,000 in the population. And so it's a very straightforward, clear question. 4B says the table shows life expectancies for babies born in the UK and in the Sudan in 2009. So you have values for males and females. And so 4B part 1 says describe the patterns shown by this data. Now there are two marks available for this question. And clearly it's a describe, and that's the key term here, describe. And so all we have to do is look at patterns in the data and identify it. So the first pattern, you're going to compare United Kingdom and Sudan, and you would say that on average, the individuals who live in United Kingdom live longer. So for instance, you could quote the numbers for UK at 76.5 for males and 50.5 in the Sudan, 81.6 for females in the UK and 52.4 in Sudan. The next comparison that you'd make is between males and females, and you would say on average that males don't live as long as females, and again, quote the numbers that are there. So a comparison between the UK and Sudan is one mark, and a comparison between males and females is the second. And finally, suggest reasons for the differences in the life expectancy shown in the data, and so there's two marks. And so you're looking for the reasons for why women live longer than men, and you could quote reasons like, for instance, employment, the types of jobs that they may take on. Necessarily, they might take better care of themselves, say better healthcare regimes, better levels of exercise, things of that nature. And then as a comparison between UK and Sudan, you probably talk about things like healthcare, again, nutrition, and availability of things like treatments or drugs. And so any one of those are valid reasons, and therefore the two marks you could get for a number of different things.